This is Apollo Control at 51 hours, 7 minutes. Apollo 7, Apollo 11's distance is 167,007 nautical miles from Earth. Velocity 3,386 feet per second.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. Did you find it? Over.
Roger, we found it.
Roger. And see, you're in Pooh. If you can give us accept, we'll uplink a new state vector to you and update the CMC clock. Over.
Okay, you got it.
Roger.
Thank you.
Houston,
11, this is Houston. We're through with the uplink. You can go back to block.
Roger, back to block.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. We would like to terminate the charge on battery B at GET of 5130. Over. Apollo 11, this is Houston. We'd like to terminate charging battery Bravo at 5130 GET, over.
Roger, terminate charging battery Bravo 5130.
Roger, out. Thank you.
This is Apollo Control at 51 hours, 25 minutes into the mission. Apollo 11 is 167,594 nautical miles from Earth, moving toward the moon at a velocity of 3,373 feet per second. All systems are normal. We will be utilizing this release line for the Colonel Frank Borman briefing. During that briefing, we will tape any air-to-ground transmissions and play them back after the briefing. This is Mission Control, Houston.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I think all of you have the statement about Luna 15 and Frank. No sound? All right. Is any sound here? Okay. I think you all have the statement on Luna 15, and Colonel Frank Borman's here just to answer any questions, and Chris Kraft, the director of flight crew operations, is making his way in case you have some other questions about trajectories. So no further ado, we're open for questions. Rudy? Wait for the mic.
I'm expecting you to do the talk. Colonel Borman, did you ask or did they give you any indication of what the mission of Luna 15 is?
They said that. That was a real burp. They said that it would remain in orbit, in its present orbit, for 2 days, and that they would notify us immediately of any future changes in the trajectory. They also said that at no time would the Lunar 15 trajectory intersect the published trajectory of Apollo 11.
Al?
They say the length of the 2 days, in other words, from when were they counting when they said 2 days?
1317 July Moscow time.
Frank, for audio purposes, would you briefly repeat what the press release says?
The press release briefly says that Dr. Kraft, called me and said, we're a little bit interested in what Luna 15 is doing, and could you check with some of the people that you met in the Soviet Union recently and see if you can find out? So I, after checking with the appropriate people, placed a call to Soviet Union and talked to Dr. Keldysh, and to his assistant who speaks English, and asked them if they could relay us any information and explain there was some interest, more than casual interest in it, on the part of the flight operations people here in Houston. And they responded with a cable that I received at home last night that gave the orbital parameters plus the indication that we just mentioned that they would inform us of any further changes.
Howard Simons?
Could either one of you tell us how you interpret what you've just told us, that it'll remain in present orbit 2 days?
That would be conjecture. So your guess is as good as ours at this point. I'm an honorary doctor.
If you're a doctor, I better move over a couple of days. Harry, Pete. We could, I'm sure Frank and myself would probably
come up with the same answer. We can only guesstimate what the Russians are doing in this instance. We've said to each other that probably we would guess they were doing a step-by-step program just as we would do a step-by-step program in this country. And they've been flying circumlunar flights with their lunar vehicles. And this flight is a lunar orbit flight in which they'll return from lunar orbit. And it's a step in their lunar exploration program.
Harry, please.
Can you translate these orbital parameters for us into an altitude, an apogee and perigee, and tell us where this is with respect to the projected Apollo 11 trajectory?
Well, the eccentricity is pretty low, and the period is about the same as ours, two hours.
We compute that to be 72 by 156 and an inclination of about 45 degrees. 72 by 156 and an inclination of about 45 degrees. 72 at perigee and 156 at apogee. Nautical miles, yes, I'm sorry.
F. Clark.
And you multiply that by 1.82 something to get kilometers.
can, Can you tell us why you held up the announcement this long?
Pardon me?
If you got this information last night or early this morning, well, why didn't you hold up until now? I didn't, quite frankly, see any...
I thought there wouldn't be any more news last night than it was this morning, and we put it out. I was at home...
He didn't talk to me until this morning.
I didn't tell Chris about it till this morning.
After all,
the important thing is here that it isn't going to bother Apollo 11, so...
Eckhart.
Chris, could we clarify what you said when you said a step-by-step program, and you said it was in lunar orbit. Did you say that you expected it to leave lunar orbit?
Art Hill.
That would be my guess, yes.
To return to Earth?
Affirmative.
Does that tell you any more about the mission?
Yeah, it says it's a lunar orbit mission.
But you're a doctor.
I'm not trying to be smart with you.
No.
I'm just guessing, and I think you would guess the same way, that the Russian programs traditionally have been very methodical in stepping through the various phases of an operation, unmanned, et cetera.
Thank you.
This is Apollo Control at 51 hours, 58 minutes into the mission. Apollo 11 is 168,658 nautical miles from Earth, traveling at a velocity of 3,349 feet per second. We have 30 seconds of air-ground conversation taped during the news briefing. We'll play that for you now.
11, this is Houston. We show you terminating battery B charge. Over. Apollo 11, this is Houston. Over. Roger, 11, we show you terminating battery B charge at about 51 hours, 30 minutes, over.
Okay.
Roger, out.
I went to.
Eleven, this is Houston. Say again, both what on, over. Apollo 11, this is Houston. Affirmative, we request hydrogen and an oxygen fuel cell purge, over.
Okay, any preference which first?
Negative, as long as...
This is Apollo Control at 52 hours, 40 minutes. Apollo 11 is 170,010 nautical miles from Earth. Velocity, 3,319 feet per second.
We'll be right back. Houston, Apollo 11, over.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. Go ahead.
Roger, you copy my now 93.
That's affirmative. We've got it.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and correct then. Triangle difference is 0.01, but it's sort of difficult. It's 3/10 rate. I'm required to use medium speed and resolved, and it's difficult to hold the star centered long enough to get a decent mark on him.
Roger, we copy, and they look okay to us.
Right.
This is Apollo Control at 53 hours, 3 minutes into the mission. Apollo 11 is 170,746 nautical miles from Earth. Velocity 3,303 feet per second. Crew is now in the process of realigning the spacecraft's inertial platform.
Thank you.
This is Apollo Control at 53 hours 20 minutes. Apollo 11's distance from Earth is 171,293 nautical miles, traveling at a velocity of 3,291 feet per second. spacecraft weight is 96,068 pounds. This is Apollo Control. We have a correction on the orbital parameters of Luna 15 as given in the news briefing recently over. The parameters given in that briefing of 72 by 156 nautical miles were based on computations from an orbital period of 2 hours and 30 minutes instead of the correct 2 hours and 30 seconds. The orbit has been recomputed based on the proper numbers, and the parameters for Luna 15 based on a period of 2 hours, 30 seconds are 30 by 110 nautical miles. Paraloon of 30, Apolloon of 110 nautical miles.
Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Go ahead, Houston.
Roger, I've got the morning news here, if you're interested, over.
Yeah, we sure are, we're ready to copy and comment.
Is that 2:30 there?
Roger.
Copy and comment. Okay,
Okay. Here we go. The interest in the flight of Apollo 11 continues at a high level, but a competing interest in the Houston area is the easing of watering rules. Mayor Louis Welch promises a lifting of lawn watering restrictions if the rains continue. Friday is partly cloudy and there is a 30% chance of thundershowers in the afternoon. In Washington, D.C., the Senate Finance Committee approved extension of the income tax surtax, but a Senate vote on the bill.
You cut out, Houston.
Roger, where do you hold me cutting out, over?
Houston, Apollo 11.
Apollo 11, Houston, over. Apollo 11, this is Houston. How do you read now? Over.
Not clear, Houston. Go ahead.
All right.
After the rains in Houston.
Roger. In Washington, the Senate Finance Committee has approved extension of the income tax surtax, but a Senate vote on the bill currently seems remote. In Austin, State Representative Ray Lemon of Houston has been nominated as a national director of the American Society for Oceanography. Lemon has proposed a study of the possibility of establishing an Institute of Oceanography in Texas. This would be the first such institute on the western Gulf of Mexico. In Minneapolis, Minnesota, the Weather Bureau, after recapping today's weather, showing a high of 88 and a low of 72, has noted snowfall, none. From St. Petersburg, Florida, comes a radio report from the Norwegian explorer Thor Heyerdahl, which said that the crew of his papyrus boat, the Ra, will sail into Bridgetown, Barbados, despite damage from heavy seas. The crew, however, will sleep on an escort vessel. Norman Baker, navigator of the expedition, said the crew was aboard the Ra today repairing damage from storms this past week, which split the footing of the mast. Part of the broken mast was jettisoned overboard, and the vessel was 725 miles east of the Barbados. It is possible but uncomfortable to sleep aboard the Ra, Baker said in the radio report. But the purpose of our voyage is not a test of strength or human endurance. That is the reason why the crew was spending nights aboard the escort vessel Shenandoah, which rendezvoused with the Ra on Tuesday. In sports, the Houston Oilers are showing plenty of enthusiasm in their early preseason workouts at Kerrville, and Coach Wally Lem says he is impressed with the fine group of rookies. National League Baseball, for yesterday, Thursday, St. Louis 11, Philadelphia 3, Montreal 5 over Pittsburgh 4, Atlanta 12, Cincinnati 2, San Francisco 14 and Los Angeles 13. American League have Baltimore 3 over Cleveland 2, Detroit 4 to Washington 3, Minnesota 8 to Chicago 5, Boston and New York was rained out. And in Corby, England, an Irishman, John Coyle, has won the World Porridge Eating Championship by consuming 23 bowls of instant oatmeal in a 10-minute time limit from a field of 35 other competitors. Over.
Roger, I assume Houston didn't play yesterday.
That's correct.
I'd like to enter Aldrin in the oatmeal eating contest next time.
See, pretty good at that.
He's doing his show up here.
Let's see, you all just finished a meal not long ago, too, didn't you?
I'm still eating.
Okay, does that,
He's on his 19th bowl.
Roger. Are you having any difficulties with gas in the food bags like the 10 crew reported?
Well, that's intermittently affirmative, Bruce. We have these two hydrogen filters which work fine as long as you don't hook them up to a food bag. But the entryway into the food bag has enough back pressure to cause the filters to start losing their efficiency. A couple of times I've been tempted to go through that dry out procedure, but we found that simply by leaving the filters alone for a couple of hours, their efficiency seems to be restored.
Roger, we copy.
Yeah, efficiency ranges everywhere from darn near perfect to terrible, just depending on the individual characteristics of the food bag we're putting to them. Some of the food bags are so crimped near the entryway that there's no way we can work them loose to prevent back pressure.
Roger.
That's Mike Collins from the spacecraft.